Hi, this is Joya from Exposé, and you're listening to Harv Roman, 1590 AM WCGO in Chicago. We love you, Harv.
WCGO Radio in Chicago, where Chicago goes for Club Kids Radio and Celebrity Hotline Conversations on a Saturday morning. In the back of your head right now is Brooke Henning. That one is entitled My Heart right here. Yep, it is 1590. It is time for an all-new Celebrity Hotline Conversation every Saturday at about this time. We bring to you the youths of the Union League Boys and Girls Clubs, of the Charter School in Irving Park, of almost any walk of life. If I run into them, and I've worked with them in the past, but they want to work with me right now, and do some radio with me, I go ahead and give them the airtime here because the youth are so important to them to listen to here at AM 1590 and elsewhere. So we do this every Saturday morning, and it is our fourth or fifth home of Club Kids Radio and Celebrity Conversation. So how cool is that? Before we go to our Celebrity Hotline Conversation, Pinqy Ring is going to be our guest on a Celebrity Hotline Conversation. She has worked with youth. She is a rapper extraordinaire. She is a personality from Humboldt Park who is doing some really good work. And we're going to hear from her in a little while. But I also want to shine the spotlight on a couple of our students over at the Charter School in Irving Park, because they're about to do some things that I thought we should talk about. So before we go to Pinqy Ring with that Celebrity Hotline Conversation, let us go now to another kind of Celebrity Hotline Conversation. It is about the youth. We are motivating them, and they're motivating us. So let's go to the Celebrity Hotline, shall we? We have two Pumas who are part of Pumarazzi. That is the newest and the only edition of the newspaper over at the Charter School in Irving Park. Anthony Wagner, Jordan Burks, how are you?
Good. I'm good, Harv.
So it's Saturday morning, and it's the day after you guys published your first newspaper. Tell me about it, Anthony.
When it was coming out, I kind of felt like really excited for it because I knew that, you know, it would be helping the school, and it would go to the DC trip, and I was just really excited for it to come out. And we raised a lot of money yesterday, so I was just really glad that it came to like a big success that I thought it would be.
It's all colors. It's four pages. There's a variety of stories in there. Jordan, tell us about some of the stories that you contributed to the edition of Pumarazzi. And it says our very first issue. It's like a collector's item now. And you notice I got you guys to autograph mine, so that way it could be worth millions later in life.
Some of ours is that we got one about our new principal, Ms. Brio, and we have some about the basketball team and stuff like that.
Tell me about the idea to put together a school newspaper. I just started my fifth year at the Charter School in Irving Park. I don't recall a student newspaper being put out before. I could be wrong, but this could be a first, no? Either one of you?
Well, I remember I wasn't here for that long, so, but while I was here at the charter school, there was no newspaper that I saw, so.
Jordan, and you've been there from the beginning, right? When CICS first opened up?
Yep.
You know how I could tell, because in Miguel's room, there is a framed picture that they took off the walls, because almost everybody in those pictures are no longer there, but there's one of you, and you look like, man, you look like you might have been in second or third grade. When did you start?
When I was in third grade.
See, I was right. It was just you. It was a little Jordan head. So tell me about your part, your role in putting that in the newspaper. Did you guys have to pitch the faculty at the school, or, you know, did you just, you were told you're putting out a newspaper? How did the idea come about?
Well, we have a student council, so people would suggest having a newspaper, and so we started with that, and then we have, like, people get pictures and poems in it, and then we have coupons for our snack sale, so we thought it would work. So.
I saw that. That might be the first time, and I'm an old guy, that might be the first time I've seen, like, school coupons inside of a school newspaper. I used to write and take pictures from my school newspaper when I was at Wells, like, a million years ago. And we never put in coupons. We put pictures and stories and stuff like that. But it's pretty neat that you can buy a school newspaper and at the same time, you know, get some of that money back, you know, if you buy tickets to a basketball game or if you wind up getting a hot dog. That was a pretty neat idea. Who put that together?
Well, from the beginning, it was kind of like my idea because I thought that it would increase the value of the newspaper. So I was thinking adding coupons would kind of be like a hook to the people who wanted to buy it, that if they're getting something out of the newspaper other than the cool stories that we have in store for them.
The way cool stories, and what I like about this too, Mr. President, the last time we talked, you were running for class president and you ended up getting that office. And one of the things when you guys run for student government is, you know, you wind up, you know, making promises and plastering walls with posters and saying, if you elect me. Well, it turns out, Anthony, you know, having been elected, you've been able to keep some of those promises that some of us thought, well, you know, they might be going too far, but you've been able to keep some of those promises. How about that?
Yeah, and I mean, it really hasn't been that long since I was installed into office, but, you know, I'm in the future, I want to try to incorporate a lot of more of the school's ideas to make the school more fun.
Well, I mean, I know there was a school dance. There was the Pumarazzi. And you guys are raising money to go to Washington, is that what it is?
Yep, Washington, D.C.
Now, what's the big evil plan when you get to Washington, D.C.? Let's say you raise enough money to go. How many kids do you think would be able to go? And what do you think you guys would be able to do when you're out there?
Well, we already, like, so kids already started making payments to go. And we have at least 28, almost 30 kids is going out of the 8th grade classroom. And we already have organized what we could go do day from day, time from time. We could go to museums and stuff like that.
Anthony, how do you see this trip to Washington in terms of what you guys are going to be able to accomplish out there?
Well, I feel that we're going to be able to go to Washington, D.C., and I feel like we're going to raise more than enough money that we need to go there. And I'm just really excited for this trip because I know it's going to be really fun.
Now, last year was interesting because there was a class that wanted to raise money last year, and I think the trip they wanted to take was to St. Louis, and they didn't quite make their goal, so they took another trip, you know, within the state, which was still cool. But you guys are a little bit different. You guys seem focused, and you really seem like you're having some successful events. I know that the dance was packed, and I know that you just about sold out of newspapers yesterday. So have you guys had to take some sort of training or classes to teach you how to do some writing and to take the pictures and whatnot?
No, not really. It's just like last year we was helping out 8th grade. So this year we have experience, so we know what we're doing.
last year, were you guys, was there like an adopting thing where the eighth graders adopted you guys as little brothers? And are you doing that this year too? How is it that you managed to hang out with upperclassmen last year, where in most school situations, the upperclassmen don't want to hang with the kids that are not upperclassmen?
Well, they didn't really want to do anything last year, so...
Yes?
Yeah. Well, I kind of feel like a lot of the friendships, I mean, our school is kind of really close and compact school, so a lot of us, you know, we really don't have that many kids in our middle school. So I guess we all try to build the relationships that we can acquire from different grade levels. And if, I guess a lot of the people in seventh grade last year made a lot of friends with eighth graders because maybe they had the same interests. Or like Jordan, his brother was in eighth grade last year, so
yeah.
Kind of roots being tied together.
Ain't been the same, no, oh, since we separated. All those golden moments we shared, we shouldn't let them go astray. No, can we talk and try to figure something out? Because your love is one thing that I don't want to be without. Oh no, let's get things back to the way they used to be. When I loved you, and baby, you loved me. I wanna get things back to the days when we were one. When life was good and love had just begun.
Let's get things back to the way they used to be. When I loved you, yeah. And baby, you were crazy.
You crazy.
I wanna get things back to the days when we were good.
Yeah.
Man, what a smooth sound. That is Jimmy C. Do you want to know who Jimmy C is? There's a tie here. We're playing like a Kevin Bacon game at 1590 AM on a Saturday morning. WCGO Radio, by the way, Club Kids Radio and Celebrity Conversations. On the Celebrity Hotline just a few minutes ago, it was Anthony Wagner and Jordan Burks, two of our kids over at the Charter School in Irving Park, talking about Pumarazzi, the new school newspaper that they have helped put together, and they wanted to talk about some of the things that they've been doing at the school. I've got another interview track with them that we'll play on later on, maybe next week on Club Kids Radio, because now we go to the Celebrity Hotline once again, and this time it is a performer, someone who also works with young people, somebody who was a young person herself, and she's still fairly young. But we ran into each other via the Facebook. But why should I tell you the entire story? Let us go back. Oh, by the way, Jimmy C. is a parent of students who go to the charter school in Irving Park. And he gave me the CD a few weeks ago, and he wanted me to hear it. And he wanted my opinion of it. And I said, well, my opinion, let's get the opinion of the listeners at 1590 AM. So if you want to review Jimmy C., at least that particular single, Reborn Love, then let us know about it, and then he'll go clickety-clicking and find out what you think about music from a parent of a student, just like Anthony and Jordan are. Now, let's go to another line on the Celebrity Hotline, shall we? I'm Harv Roman here, and we go to the Celebrity Hotline to somebody who I can honestly say that I don't know, but I'd like to get to know, and so we kind of reached each other, in a roundabout way through the Facebook. Ladies and gentlemen, I mean, it's Marisol Velez, but people call you Pinqy Ring, don't they?
Yes, they do.
So hi, how are you?
I'm doing fantastic, actually, and cooking dinner and talking to you, so I don't think that my Thursday night could have gotten any better.
Well, I mean, we had to get in that last episode of 30 Rock, and so that's all out, and it's over with. And I too was doing my my famous combination of chicken noodle soup mixed into white rice, and I'll get back to that in a little bit. But as soon as the celebrity hotline rang, I knew I had to get to it, because we've had a couple of dates before to record this conversation, and it just didn't occur, so I wanted to get it as soon as we can get it, and so I appreciate you getting in on it.
Thank you for having me.
I'm trying to recall how it was that we wound up reaching out to each other. I'm assuming via the Facebook. I know that I put in a request, and it says I want to interview you, and you're from the city, and you're a rapper, but up until you had sent me some tracks, maybe a week and a half ago, I was really not aware of you. You just were somebody who I thought that our listeners should get to know.
Yeah, and I do believe it was via the interwebs. I think that just connects so many different people. And I know we spoke about having worked in the same community different times, unfortunately. But it's a small world, but people really don't know each other as well as they should. So I'm really glad that you reached out, and I'm really glad to have this conversation as a conversation versus a very boring interview, in air quotes. So.
Marisol or Pinqy Ring. Am I talking to Marisol now, or am I talking to Pinqy Ring? Do we have like two different personas?
We do have two personas, but I've learned to mesh the two of them together into just one person. But there's times like the very braggy kind of I have a lot of boyfriends jokester is Pinqy Ring, and then the educator, the poet, is Marisol. But I have found a way to mesh the two of them together, so I'm glad that I finally was able to learn how to do that.
And I think that's one of the things that really excited me when I read a little bit about you via the Facebook and the internet. You were tight with the Albizu Campos Alternative High School, and when we had done the math, it turned out that we didn't cross paths, but I was the former
director. Other two.
I was the former director of the Boys and Girls Club right there in Division and Washington, the Miguel Ebrero Club. I was the first director for the new building, and then I was director of the program for the 2 years that it was at Von Humboldt School, waiting for the new building to get built. And budget cuts cost me at the beginning of 2009, and it turns out 2009 or so was when you started, you know, what you were doing in Humboldt Park with Campos High School. So it would have been neat to have met you at that point, because we had developed back in, when I first started at Barreto, we started the collaboration with Campos where they would bring their kids into our building to use
the gym.
Yeah, they were doing the gym classes, and they were doing things upstairs in the game room, and it was a pretty neat thing, because at the camp, Campos hadn't yet expanded the way they had, and so it was a pretty small operation. And when they asked about it, I said, well, why not? You know, these are our kids, these are our community, this is our culture. How could I not open up the doors to the Boys and Girls Club for them to use it when we weren't using it before the kids got there at 2 o'clock or so?
Mm-hmm.
So
it was actually really awesome to see that. Like, we had a staff versus student basketball game, and it was at the facility. We won, obviously, staff won, because we're awesome. But it was just awesome to see that, you know, just Humboldt Park as a community, how together they are and how they do come together, like you said, for the kids. Those are our kids, and so we all have to work together. And that's something, even though I don't work at Campos anymore, is something that it's on my mind all the time. And the reason why I do my music is to be able to give back in the fashion that I wasn't able to financially.
And I'll say the same thing. Throughout the years, I had put in more than 30 years with Boys and Girls Clubs, and so even though things got put on pause for a little while, I says, no. I got married to this community, so I'll continue to do things. So we kept the radio show. We kept working with some of the other community organizations, and my parents are still on Campbell and Division, so I will not be leaving the Big Flights of Steel anytime soon.
Yeah.
So tell us a little bit about yourself. You're not only Marisol Velez, but you're also Pinqy Ring. You could have been, you know, the regular ring. You could have been a nose ring. You could have been...
And I do have a nose ring.
Well, you know what? These days, what isn't pierced these days? So,
well, I the name Pinqy Ring, I actually hated the color pink altogether. I grew up as a tomboy. Once I finally wore pink in high school, people started calling me Pinky, even people that I didn't meet. And my hair wasn't pink at the time, and it is now. So people just started calling me Pinky. And then when I met my first music manager when I was a minor still, he called me Pinky too. So I was like, okay, this is going to stick. Everyone's calling me this. They don't know who I am, even if I wasn't wearing pink. So I was like, okay, I'm big on omens and signs. So I was like, okay, I'll take it. But I didn't want it to be just Pinky, because there's a million of them everywhere. Like, I'm sure you know a Pinky somewhere. So I added the ring because I was really enthralled with the Italian culture, and you know, kissing the Pinky ring out of respect, and then marrying that with the hip hop culture where every rapper has a line about their pinky ring, or they talk about or brag about it, and that was kind of me. As a woman rapper, when I would go to parties and things, people would want to show me off. And so that's where Pinky Ring came from, and I've been rapping for a very, very long time. And really, this year is kind of the year that it's coming more to a whole fruition versus the other years where I kind of just stepped my toes in it and then just went back out because I was so busy teaching and doing poetry and everything other than music.
They say silence is gold. If you could read between the lines, but swiftly swallow syllables and symbols once they drift the real rhymes. We ought to make a rise, but they sleep, and we know those creeping with secretive eyes. Unsuspicious in size, like Trayvon Martin, but we still suspect, so we keep on marching. I'm so Che, I'm so on target. I'm so Lady of Rage, so we keep on marching. Graduated from college, so here's my commencement. Stop asking why I'm so apprehensive. I know gente that can't read or write a sentence. Instead, construct sentences with the wrong pen. You can't deny what's right or wrong when we got no white out to cover up and rewrite our offenses. We got a menace, the people's amendment, so humanish that they wanna vanquish us. They telling us we can't speak no more. Selling the street, but see, we can't feed our own and be our own. People, where have we gone wrong? They telling us we can't eat no more. Cheeks, but see, they can't teach our own. Who gon' get up and lead? Where have we gone wrong? The revolution will not be tweeted. The revolution will not be Facebook deleted. Our voices, and we got no choice when they dictate the schools and the projects and our people in the state pen. This is for Aaliyah, 6, killed in the shy streets. A princess never grown to a queen because the kings, and it's their fault. But who planted the seeds? Who gave them reason to find love in every other thing except themselves? Reckless, we chucked them to hell. The minute we were born in color or in poor wealth, we need to raise our brave new voices, or else we'll be waiting forever for the 1% to help. Silence has kept us making minimum wage. Kept hip-hop bragging about the money they don't make. The guns they don't really want to use, but we've been abused. Beating scars shook like my deep hooks. They telling us we can't speak no more. Selling the street, but see, we can't feed our own and be our own.
Background is one of those that, you know, if somebody was just trying to come up with a character to portray Pinky Ring, they wouldn't have put in the ingredients that you've done. You're educated. You know, you've gone to some prominent schools. You've got a degree. You've worked with young people. And a lot of times, well, you read the papers. You know what's happening with a lot of the rappers where they're having these issues and people are dying and then reputations are it's so negative, it's ridiculous to open up the paper and read about some of those things. You should be one who is focused on in terms of the publicity and the news, but not only for your talent, but for the fact that you've done things that kids that you grew up with weren't quite able to do. A lot of dropouts, a lot of kids not going to college, a lot of kids not working, or at least the kind of jobs that we would be proud of.
Mm-hmm.
So tell me about, you know, you dipped your toe, you said, into so many other different things. Well, you could have done other things. Knowing the population at Campos, for people who don't know about Campos as a school, it is an alternative high school, but it's one of those high schools that kind of embraces kids that have not been embraced, for lack of a better term, by traditional schools. These are kids that have challenges. These are kids that a lot of people don't want to work with. These are kids that if you saw them walking down the street, you might go on the other side of the street so you don't have to, you know, face up to them. And then here you are, somebody who's educated, but somebody who is keeping a bit of the street culture along with the educated Pinqy Ring or Marisol Velez.
Unfortunately, I made a lot of mistakes, and I did all the bad things that a lot of young people do, just for lack of guidance or lack of identity, in a sense. I fell in love with music, with hip-hop particularly, and grew up in a very religious household, Pentecostal, so long hair, you can't cut your hair, can't color your hair, can't wear pants. You know, I was dying to find my identity, and that wasn't it for me. So being that I went along kind of this hip-hop path, I made a lot of mistakes. I hung out with a lot of the wrong people. I did a lot of really stupid things. And it took a car accident in 2004 where I was in a coma. I broke my teeth. I have a temporal lobe contusion on my brain that affects my memory sometimes. It took that for me to transform my life. I had dropped out of UIC. I didn't see the value in it because my family, they came from Puerto Rico, and they were about, you know, you graduate high school and then you work. And although my mom pushed me to go to college, I couldn't help them financially, and they were struggling. So I felt like college wasn't of value at the moment. So after this accident, I went back to school. My major was biology. I wanted to be a marine biologist. I changed it to English. Then I changed it to teaching. Then I changed it to creative writing and fiction, and that's what I stuck with. Graduated, and then that was my opportunity. That car accident was my opportunity to look back at my life and say, you're not doing the right thing, and I'm going to shake your world up a little bit. And unfortunately, a lot of the youth, like Campos youth, or, you know, the youth in Chicago, don't get that opportunity. They won't wake up from that coma, or they will be at the wrong place at the wrong time. I've lost a lot of friends due to street violence or wrong decisions. So for me, it was imperative that I took that experience and made it something positive so that I have something to give back to my community, and so that I can help those kids who are going down the same path that I went down. And being a rapper helps me, because I come into the classroom as, you know, teacher, but I have pink hair, I have piercings, I'm like them, and then I rap, and I know all about the culture and the things that they like and they do, and I infuse that into the classroom. We analyze songs, and we read articles about artists, and we think critically about the music industry that we're in, and it just seems like now is the point for me to take that nationally and then globally. And like you said, people don't put on those who are doing good things. So fine, I'll rap. I'll do that thing that people enjoy and like, and I'm really good. But I deserve the opportunity to make it bigger than what it is right now because of my mission. And I, for that reason, lately I've been kind of, I guess what you would call, media darling. I just got the cover of Hype magazine because the executive editor believes in everything that I stand for and everything that I'm doing. So I just hope to bring a shift to that negativity that you were talking about. I hope to bring a shift to this kind of rapper persona where, you know, gangs, drugs, violence. I want to make it about good music, but I also want to make it about what are you giving back to the world? How are you going to leave the world better than when you came into it? And so that's my job, and I'm working really, really hard to make it full-time, to make it happen all the way.
That is so cool. It's kind of some of the things that you're saying are some of the things that I, too, believed when I was, you know, at the Boys and Girls Club in Humboldt Park. Also, I had years and years in West Hunter, the Boys and Girls Club, and we used to do some of the similar type of things where we would take song lyrics and we would try to get the kids to try to explain. In essence, I would play dumb to get the kids to try to explain the lyrics to me, and then we would.
What does this mean?
Yeah, and then we would do a little analyzing, and some of the stuff, you know, because I've done radio work with kids for years. We would play it on the air, and then we would let the kids kind of try to tell me what it meant. And of course, like I say, I played dumb just to get them to explain a little bit about the music that they grew up on or were understanding at that point, because, you know, and you're probably about 20 years younger than I am, you know, people in your generation looked at by people of my generation as, well, what do they know, and listen to what they're listening to, and all they think about you guys is bad news most of the time. And the bottom line is that is so not true. That is Pinqy Ring, Marisol Velez, something entitled Dream Big. And that's what we're doing right here at 1590 AM WCGO Radio, where Chicago goes for Club Kids Radio and Celebrity Hotline Conversations on a Saturday morning. We also heard music from Jimmy C, Love Reborn. And we heard music from Pinqy Ring, Silence Is Not Gold. And at the top of the program, what did we play? What was the first song we played? It was Brooke Penning with My Heart. I didn't write it down. I almost forgot about it. My name is Harv Roman. Every Saturday at about this time, you can listen to Club Kids Radio and Celebrity Conversations. And if you miss any of it, run over to www.wakeupdancing.com. Pinqy Ring, somebody new, somebody exciting. Not so new to the Humboldt Park area, but new to the airwaves here at 1590 AM. And a lot of the music that we're playing, well, obviously, it's going to be from her collection. And it's very socially conscious, and it's something that makes you want to think a little bit. So try to dissect the lyrics as we're listening to the music here at 1590 AM. Wow, it's already 33 minutes after the hour. We've only got until 7 o'clock in the morning, unless you're online, and you can just pause it and run around and do whatever you need to do. But we'll take our breakicito now, and we'll return more. Club Kids Radio.
Alex Rodriguez of the New York Yankees talks about the Boys and Girls Clubs.
When I was 9, my mom had to work 2 full-time jobs to keep our family together. She didn't get home till 11. The streets were there, but for my sake, so was the Boys and Girls Club.
The Boys and Girls Club is a positive place for kids to go every day after school, to do homework, make friends, and play ball.
Eddie Rodriguez ran the Boys and Girls Club in my neighborhood, and he still does today. He taught me to believe in myself, to be positive, stay grounded, and to keep my eye on the ball. I still come back to train at the Boys and Girls Club. With Eddie, he's like a father to me.
There are more than 3,000 Boys and Girls Clubs where caring people like Eddie are helping our kids succeed.
Does it work? It did for me. Support the Boys and Girls Clubs, the positive place for kids.
Call 1-800-854-CLUB.
Wake up! Wake up! Dancing! Wake up! Wake up! Dancing!
Ring right here at 1590 AM WCGO Radio in Chicago, where Chicago goes for Club Kids Radio and Celebrity Hotline Conversations on a Saturday morning. This Saturday morning, Celebrity Hotline, devoted to Marisol Velez, also known as the performing artist of Pinqy Ring, does some spoken word, and does some rapping and some poetically things. And I'm trying to cue up her next song, and my CD deck is acting silly a little bit, so you might get some dead air for just a smidge, but not before we go to the Facebook, right? You guys have been clickety-clicking, and so I have to give you some respect when you click on me, right? Myra, Josie, Kathy, Carol, Carmen, Louie's in Florida, Gina, Mercy, Gladys, Madeline, Aurora, Leslie, Tony G, who sent us music recently, as did Leslie Jones, by the way, Sonia, Tuti, Amirna, Chris, Andrew, Maria, Sarai, Juan, Denise, Sal, Moises, Monica, Blanca, Elena, Carlos, Jesus, Bill, Julia, Sonia, Rudy, Juana, Rosa, Teresa, former Club Kid Jimmy as well, Yvette was another former Club Kid, Nadine, Jamie, Arturo, Al, Yuyo, and Josephine, who still works at the Miguel A. Barreto Union League Boys and Girls Club, and she's been on the air with us, and her daughters have been on the air with us, and so it's very, very cool to have such a long line of Club Kid Radio in terms of guests and music artists and things like that, and hopefully Marisol Velez, Pinqy Ring will be one of those that we'll have on over and over again as time moves on, and I'm trying to cue up her song, and it's not queuing up. What is wrong with this CD thing? We have to play more of the interview, obviously, and I want to play the music that belongs to her, so let me grab something else, and then we can play some more music from her and some more interview. It's 36 after the hour, heading on to the top of the hour. Whatever we run out of room for in terms of this particular radio program next weekend, if we have to devote the entire hour to the interview and to the music that doesn't want to be queued up right now, then that's what we will do, because I am devoted just like you are. You make the effort to click, you make the effort to tune in, and since you do that, I will be able to do this. So we'll just play some more music now from Pinqy Ring, and then we will have more Celebrity Hotline Conversation. Ah, live radio. How fun is this?
To change the game, man, on you assholes. She got mad flow, put me on your favorite show. I got some new flavor for your ear hole. Yeah, yo, I'm a fly shy chicken. I said it, but I'll say it again and again. Then come to the station, fist is waving, cause I'ma get a deal soon. Heavy rotation, like
whatever I like, I put it on my radio. Aye. You could probably find something new on my radio. Aye. If you wanna ride, cool, just don't touch my radio. Aye. Don't look so surprised. You can trip if you want, but don't front. You know you love it. Put it on the radio. Don't front. You know you love it. Put it on the radio. Don't be scared. You could crank it, bruh. Just turn up the radio. Don't be shy. You could shake it, girl. Just turn up the radio. Everywhere I be, I see shouties be loving the way I rock my hat. Fresh tie on a button up. Fresh denims with a fresh vest or a sweater on. Fresh pair of frames or some fresh Adidas shells. Cause everywhere I go, they always want a picture. Whispering in my ear, is there anybody with ya? Want an autograph or they just trying to get a answer to questions like, what you listening to? I tell them whatever I like, I put it on my radio. Aye. You could probably find something new on my radio. Aye. If you wanna ride, cool, just don't touch my radio. Aye. Don't look so surprised. You can trip if you want, but don't front. You know you love it. Put it on the radio. Don't front. You know you love it. Put it on the radio. Don't be scared. You could crank it, bro. Just turn up the radio. Don't be shy. You could shake it, girl. Just turn up the radio.
Now it's time for verse 2. I know you've been waiting. Requested on the fresh line so I can get paid and laid. Everybody need her. Watch out for the 808. Hick a bunch of tweeter. Shorty tryna holler. I told him that I'm single. He buy me what I want.
Yeah. If they would give it the chance or the opportunity, and I would even encourage teachers to try to step outside of the box, you know, whatever it is you're teaching, some of the best teachers are the ones who can adapt to their students' needs, you know, so you have this kind of canon of literature that you have to teach, but okay, you can veer off of that path a little bit and get their interest, because that's what's going to get them to stay in school. That's why I adore everything that Campos does, because Matt Rodriguez, the principal, allowed me to be who I am. He didn't make me color my hair. He let me teach a hip-hop creative writing class. He let me take my students to the studio, record songs, and they became better people because of it, because they had a teacher who went above and beyond and really genuinely cared, but also who related to all the things that either they were going through or that they liked. And you don't have to be a pink-haired rapper to do that. You just have to be a someone who really genuinely desires to change the students that you're working with. So any teacher, I don't care if you're, you know, a 80-year-old volunteer teacher, you know, finding that common ground will get them to listen. And that's what we need. We need these kids to listen, and we need them to want to follow your advice. If you won't come to their level, there's no point.
And I think, Marisol, that's where so much of it is missed. The young people have voices, and the voices are not necessarily being listened to. And too many times, the kids that don't get listened to in traditional ways look for other ways for people to hear their voices, and then it becomes a gang issue, then it becomes a drug issue, then it becomes a violence issue. Mm-hmm. And a lot of the times, if they were paid mind to when they were coming up and they had something to say, who knows if they would have made those turns.
Absolutely. And it's a lot of, you know, you're not good enough. And they hear that everywhere in their homes, in their community. Like, that's why school is that the one place where they need to hear you are good enough. Your story is good enough. It's a different story. Maybe it's not something that, you know, a Harvard graduate would be interested in, but I am. I want to know what your story is, and tell me that. And that's what we did through creative writing. And that same person that you mentioned who didn't get listened to, that was me. And that's why I went and veered off on the wrong path and did all those wrong things, until finally the world kind of shook me and said, hey, you're not doing what you're supposed to be doing, and your mission is bigger than this. But people didn't listen to me. I still feel like people don't listen to me, you know, being a woman in the hip-hop industry, being really, really good at what I do. I've been doing this for so long that I know I'm good. It almost caused me to doubt myself and doubt my abilities and capabilities.
Well, the thing is, Marisol, you've been doing it for years now, and so for you, it's something that you've been beating your head against the wall for a long time to get discovered and get the hype that you deserve. But on the other hand, for the traditional media, you're spanking brand new, so you're like a rookie to them.
Absolutely.
Even though you're a veteran in the game. Talking to Marisol Rivera, Marisol, not Rivera, Velez, known as Pinqy Ring, the artist. I appreciate the fact I opened up my email. I think it was just a couple of days ago. You sent me like 18 tracks. You got stuff everywhere.
I do. But you're right. You know what? What you said was exactly right. Is I'm new to them now. I'm completely brand new. And, you know, I think I have to kind of look at it that way. I have been looking at it like I've been doing this for so long, but now is when everything is starting to pick up. So it is brand new. And that's why I'm really glad to have the new opportunity to release music that I feel is really aligned to my views and my visions. My first mixtape, I hear it, and sometimes I'm like, ugh, I don't really like it. But that was me. That was who I was at that moment. But now it's like, and not so much to say that I'm going to release Christian music or super clean music with no cursing, because that's who I am. But at the same time, that's why I sent you the song that I sent you that I haven't released yet, because I wanted you to hear kind of what's in the works now. And I have love songs, I have fun songs, party songs, but, you know, that particular song that's called Silence Is Not Gold is about, you know, social and political commentary. And I want to be that person without beating you over the head with it. You know, I want to just make people think, and I want them to want to make the world better.
Well, it's important to do this because you're going to stand for quite a few demographics. You know, there's the female demographic, there's the Latina demographic, there's the youth demographic, there's the Humboldt Park demographic, and at the risk of repeating myself from what I said earlier, you know, these guys that are shooting each other and having these supposed, you know, rap feuds are taking young rappers and throwing their reputations in the toilet, when there's people like you who are doing some really positive things. But if you, you know, send out a press release saying, you know, I'm Pinqy Ring and I'm, you know, 20-something years old, and this is what I'm about, they'll look at you in the same light as they are looking at these guys that are causing problems. And that's something that we just can't have.
Yeah, and just speaking on press releases, you know, like I just released 2 songs, and what's funny is that because I'm a writer, I was able to write my own press release, so very useful and economical. But I do, in everything I do, I always mention kind of who I am and what I do, even if it's just sending out the press release, like, hey, but I'm not only that, I'm this too, because I just think that that's something that should be highlighted. I was told once that that doesn't matter by an A&R, a music A&R. I told them, yeah, and I, you know, I've traveled a lot and I volunteered in other countries and I teach and I graduated college, and a music A&R told me that doesn't matter. And it broke my heart because I was like, well, why am I doing this for? And it almost took me having to reassure myself, like, Pinqy, Marisol, that does matter. And what you're doing does matter. And I hear it every day, whether it's the students that I teach now or my former students reaching out and seeing my magazine cover and them saying, we knew you could do it, or thank you for being an inspiration to me. Like, those things do matter. And I want anyone listening to know that whatever it is they're doing does matter if they have good intention and if they're genuinely trying to create some tangible change in the world.
Well, I mean,
in whatever capacity.
Strap my boots and hit the ground running, but it seems now that he really didn't want it. Lost and found, now I reach my epiphany. I can't love him if I don't love me. So I made a decision to take a step back, moonwalking on the map like Michael Jack. Cause the reality is, no matter how handsome and fashionable, cash abundant he may be, you can't let a cute face take your sanity. And they never took a walk in your feet when the world is suffocating. All you gotta do is breathe. I'm a shooting star, I shine for me. Me, he can never put a worth in your soul. She isn't the one that's gonna help you grow. You are kings and queens and royalty. We are all stars, sing the song with me. Come on, I'm a star, my light is sparkling. I got a little swagger in my walk, and I put a little pep in pimpin' like, cause I only got one and it is mine. Yeah, I'm a star and my light is sparkling. I got a little swagger in my walk, and I put a little pep in pimpin' like, cause I only got one and it is mine. And I shine just like a diamond. You don't need money or even the finest shit. She is classy and refined, and it's my time, so let me shine. Get on yourself to save the world, cause what else she gonna give to the boys and girls? Teach yourself so you can teach the seeds, and the world will reach a peace indeed. Yes indeedy, life is beautiful, but you can't see it till you choose to grow. And if you didn't know, then now you know. You can count on me to teach you, be the pupil. And I know when it rains it pours, but when your head's underwater, just grab a snorkel, start swimming to the top of your happiness, cause it's your time and you are blessed. Yes, I'm a star, my light is sparkling. I got a little swagger in my walk, and I put a little pep in pimping like, cause I only got one and it is mine. Yeah, I'm a star and my light is sparkling. I got a little swagger in my walk, and I put a little.
Doesn't matter, is an A&R person that doesn't have his feet on the ground and his ears to the streets, because they don't last. You know, someone like you, when you make your splash, when you make your music, you wind up on magazine covers, you get newspaper articles, you get radio interviews, you're going to impact people in so many more ways than whoever the supposed A&R person was. And so it does matter. It matters because young people are going to relate to you. They're going to relate to the way you dress. They're going to relate to the way you tatted yourself up. They're going to relate to the way that, even though you grew up in a very conservative household, look at you. You said you broke all the rules.
All of them. and made some new ones, too.
So, you know, there are plenty that are going to want to follow in your footsteps. And if not for your background being out there, how are these people supposed to relate to you?
Yeah.
Now, if you want, Marisol, you could go. You could do like Barbie Girl 2013 and become a Billboard Top 10 hit and only have that impact for like 3 minutes. Or you can have the impact for years and years and years with the socially conscious things that you do and the stuff that you're still doing for young people, and not worry so much about, you know, somebody who said, well, your background doesn't matter. Because, you know, if you have no background, you have no backbone, and apparently that person has no backbone.
Yeah, and so, you know, that person is still in the industry, but just, you know, I see the kind of I understand now, you know, the music industry is not so much concerned with all of that. They want hit music and that's it. But again, like you said, if I'm trying to create longevity in this industry, those things do matter. And I almost had to remind myself of that because that person genuinely broke my spirit. I was like, oh, okay. I thought that that was going to be my thing. I thought that was going to be my story, and that's why people were going to love me, because I'm not just some hood chick rapper. You know, like, I'm smart, and I give back, and I love to travel, and it was almost even him saying that to me was very empowering. So I needed that. I take everything, and it's a lesson. So I needed to hear that, because it pushed me even more to do more of those things. Like, oh, really? That doesn't matter? Well, watch me do 17, pick up 17 more jobs working in the community. And honestly, that's how I got this magazine cover, was because they were all about my music, but more than that, all about me as a writer, as a journalist, as a person who writes for publications, and a person who writes stories and writes poetry and helps the community, and those things matter. And I just want people to see that and know that they can do more than one thing. People are so stuck with this, you know, go to college and get this job because I'm going to get money. Like, you can work so many different jobs, and it just makes you a better person overall.
So you're on the cover of the Hype magazine. It's a magazine, I guess that's an industry magazine, you know, for the rap community. Is that something that's easily picked up?
Yeah, it's just thehypemagazine.com, and you can purchase the magazine, and it is, I believe, $7.40, and you get an instant digital copy, so you can read it right away. They mail it right to you. And yeah, it's issue 73. And you can even follow them on Twitter, The Hype Magazine, and pick it up. I've been getting a lot of good feedback, a lot of support, a lot of people picking it up and taking pictures with it and sending it to me. I love it. I'm absolutely in love with everything that's happening right now, because I just feel like it's about time. I've worked really hard, and it's about time.
What made you decide that this would be your path in terms of being a performer and, you know, writing the types of lyrics that you do, and, you know, listening to, I'm not going to lie to you and say listen to all 18 songs. I think I got through like 6 tracks, and I started with, because I'm picking out, okay, what I'm going to be able to play, what I'm not going to be able to play.
Yeah.
Well, to the virgin ears, you know, there's going to be some blushing, but then you've got, but then you've got some commentary on some of your tracks too. And for somebody as young as you are, you know, you're quite a bit experienced if you listen to some of your lyrics.
And I think it's just kind of the life I led and the people I've met, the places I've visited. If there's one thing that I would love for young people to do, it's to travel outside of the U.S. More so in like a volunteer type of position, because you learn so much about yourself in relation to other people, but also other cultures and other countries. So what made me decide to do this, or to be the kind of performer or rapper I am, was just being genuinely in love with it. No one in my family really was what we call like a hip-hop head. Nobody really listened to hip-hop, so nobody was able to teach me the ropes. So I taught myself. This was back when, you know, Napster was still running, and I would just download a bunch of songs and write down the lyrics and memorize them. And it was just with the culture and with the lyrics and the way that they could just weave words together and make people happy or sad or angry or just vibe to the music, that it was the love for the culture. I am a huge hip-hop head. If anyone's on my personal Facebook page, most of my statuses are just songs. I'll put the song up and people will be like, oh my god, you know, you're taking me back, or oh, that's my song. I am in love with rap music and hip hop, but not only that, I like all kinds of music. So I'll put Spanish songs up, or I'll put rock songs or R&B. I just love music, and it's something that calls to me. It calls to the inside of me, where it's like, this is what you're supposed to do. Even though I do, you know, education does the same thing to me, and learning new things does the same to me, but I really feel that in order to get to where I want to in the world, this is the path for me. because I adore music as much as I adore waking up every morning and seeing my students' faces. So I want to give that the chance and opportunity that I did educating myself and that I did educating other people. Everyone has always come before me, and it's about time that I put myself first and give myself music therapy. And the only way I can do that is by fully immersing myself into music and trying to make that my full-time job.
Well, before we go, and I know I've kept you, and you know, we thought that this might be, you know, a 15 or 20 minute conversation.
Oh, I knew it was going to be longer. I just had a feeling.
Well, you know, Marisol, I have these long-winded questions that if you're not paying attention and taking notes, I might just lose you, and I don't do it intentionally. I just talk a lot.
No, I'm the same way. I mean, I do, you know, I write for a couple of publications, and I'm the same way. I like to have conversations. Like, I don't want to, okay, where were you born? Okay, how old are you? You know, I like talking and having good conversations. So I know usually my interviews go an hour.
If you were a tree, what kind of tree would you want to be?
If you were to reincarnate, well, actually, I just was teaching my students about reincarnation because I'm Buddhist, and they were really interested in learning about it. So they were like, oh, so do you believe in reincarnation? I'm like, yeah, absolutely. And then we started talking about it, and they were so interested. So I made a worksheet for them, and it was really cool.
So is it possible that in a previous incarnation that you might have been influenced by the Sugar Hill Gang and Curtis Blow?
And I was probably, I believe, honestly, in my heart of hearts, that I was a Puerto Rican revolutionary.
Now, why do you think that? That's an interesting thought.
Because my family, or my mom and my dad, they tell me that I'm more Puerto Rican than they are, and they're from the island. But I'm always talking about, you know, the political status of Puerto Rico and how I want to go and live there. And they're like, "We left from there. You don't want to live there." And I'm like, "I do. Eventually, my main goal is to be famous musically and then just go to Puerto Rico and live there and spend the rest of my days there."
Well,
so I feel like that's got to be something, some past life coming through me, because it wasn't like my mother or my father taught that to me, or like they were really revolutionary. So I just feel like that's something that's called me from a past life, maybe a mission in a past life that I didn't fulfill, and that's what I'm here for now.
What
so I really do believe I was a Puerto Rican revolutionary.
Well,
maybe Lolita Lebron or Alviso Campos.
Well, there you go. Very interesting, because I look at the Facebook and the hometown says Arecibo, Puerto Rico. One of my parents is Mayagüez, and the other one of my parents is Arecibo, and I've never set foot in Puerto Rico, which is horrible.
Harv, are you serious? That's what you need to do. You need to make that happen. ASAP.
Well, you know, when things were beautiful and wonderful and the world was Disney and I could afford it, I never did it because I was too busy working. And now that I'd really like to do it, I can't afford it.
I would be happy.
But now, so apparently you've been to the island?
Yes, several times.
So when I look at Arecibo, Puerto Rico, and I know that mom or pop, one of them, I don't remember which, is from Arecibo, what am I missing out on? Having not been there?
Well, just in general, not being there, it's just as soon as you get off of the plane and out of the airport, just the air is different. It's cleaner. It feels like home. It feels like everything you're missing.
My name is Harv Roman. I'm 49 years old. I am Puerto Rican. And I have never set foot in Puerto Rico. I'm so sorry. Wow, look at the time. A celebrity hotline conversation with Pinqy Ring, Marisol Velez, sitting ovation. What a very cool conversation. And that was like our first conversation, either on or off the air, except just setting it up. And that's what I wanted. I wanted something that was, you know, keeping you on your toes, keeping you listening to the microphone to find out what was going to come next. And the music was pretty much the same way. I previewed it. And then there were some of the songs that I played that I hadn't previewed before, but it's okay. My thanks to you, the listener, for putting up with me, to DJ, and to Marisol, Pinqy Ring, for the pleasure of doing a celebrity hotline conversation with her. Obviously, we still have tracks to go, so next week, 1590 AM, some more with me and Pinqy Ring. Maybe I'll wear one. See you soon.
Silence is not gold for the single mother with little to no help raising little graves on her own. For female MCs trying to put on, trying to make songs while still respecting self. For women not equal to everyone else. For little boys who never had anyone show them how to be men. The immigrant crossing the border fearing death is upon him. For babies having babies, for him with no hope, so his church is 380. Silence is not gold for the broken heart, for the broken soul. Silence is not gold, not gold.
They telling us we can't speak no more. Fell in the street, but see we can't feed our own and beat our own. People, where have we gone wrong? They telling us we can't eat no more. Blue cheeks, but see they can't teach our own. Who gon' get up and lead? Where have we gone wrong? They telling us we can't speak no more. Selling the street, but see we can't feed our own and beat our own. People, where have we gone wrong? They telling us we can't eat no more. Blue cheeks, but see they can't teach our own. Who gon' get up and lead? Where have we gone wrong?